Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Grace Church Cathedral. My name is Nicholas Kordokis, and I am the director of music and organist here at Grace. It is a great honor that you're here with us for this evening's program, a Baroque meditation. Tonight is really a landmark moment for the music at Grace. This concert marks the very first time in our program's history that the choirs have collaborated with a period instrument ensemble, and we are particularly pleased to welcome the North Carolina Baroque Orchestra, including their executive director, Barbara Krumdick. Some may ask, why go through the trouble of employing a Baroque orchestra? And to that I say, the proof will be in the pudding, I guarantee you. But I think that you'll hear that this 300-year-old music will take on such a vibrant and living character with a depth of expression and nuance that fits the music absolutely perfectly. However, this kind of living and breathing music doesn't happen on its own, and it's not possible without your support. Here at Grace, we believe that sacred music should be accessible to all people, regardless of their ability to pay a ticket price. And if you are in a position to give, at the conclusion of the concert, there will be ushers in the back with collection baskets. And even if you forgot your checkbook, you're still in luck, where there is a QR code on page 11 of your program. And you're able to give with credit card if you wish to do that way. But in all cases, I can assure you that the music that is donated goes directly to funding sacred music events, just like this one. If you're interested in more events, concerts, evensongs, other special choral services, there's also a sheet in the back with the ushers where if you'd like to be part of our email list to know about these sorts of events, there is a form with that you can give your name and contact information. But before we begin, there is just a few special thanks in order. First, to Dean Michael Wright and all of the clergy here at Grace Church Cathedral, whose constant support of high-quality church music really, truly makes events like these possible. Also, I'd like to especially thank the communications team, to Chris Prohaska and Nancy Dutrow, for their production of printed materials and publicity. Musically, we wish to thank Dr. Murray Somerville for loaning us this beautiful chamber organ for tonight's performance. Now, at this point, please double and triple check that your phones are silenced. And without further ado, we present a Baroque meditation starting with the music of Bach.
Come, come, come.
But in any case, we welcome the full orchestra. But during these few moments of the actual set change, I want to talk just a smidgen about the centerpiece of today's program. We already heard the great music of Johann Sebastian Bach, his great double choir motet. And now we go to Dietrich Buxtehude's Membra Jesu Nostri. Buxtehude was perhaps the most highly revered church organist of the 17th century, or really the most revered organist in Northern Europe of the entire 17th century. When Bach was 20 years old, he trekked 250 miles on foot to go visit Buxtehude, meet him, and essentially to serve as his apprentice. The piece before us is Membra Jesu Nostri Patientis Sanctissima, which translates to the limbs of the most holy of our of our suffering Jesus. And why such a graphic and gruesome title? The Baroque period saw a resurgence of mystical poetry from the Middle Ages, mystical poetry based on secular love metaphors. Meditations on the wounds of Christ became popular devotional texts, and for a 17th century German Lutheran, meditating on the wounds of Christ were not a sort of cultic veneration, but were rather a remembrance of divine love. The wounds were the greatest tokens of Christ's love towards the believer, like the love of a husband and a spouse. Thus, each wound is interpreted allegorically and invites the performer and listener alike to dwell inside of those wounds. There's one moment that I want to highlight in this piece, and that will also involve its own little bit of set change, and that is the sixth movement, Ad Cor, to the heart. Buxtehude changes the instrumentation from the violins and violone that you see here to a consort of five viols. And you will instantly hear this tender, almost introspective shift in the tone. And I'm really convinced that it's at that moment that Buxtehude is really melting your heart. On the title page of the composition, Buxtehude writes, Devozione decantata, that is, a sung devotion. In other words, this is not liturgical music that he's writing, but it's music meant to move the individual in a setting just like this. And it is our hope that whatever your spirituality, this 300-year-old music will give comfort and inspiration. So here is Buxtehude's Membra Jesu.
Thank you. Thank you. Spirit.